Coming up on MCTV this week, with farming season in action, we take a look at what dangers local farmers face, and we also take you back to the late 1800s. This week starts now. Welcome to MCTV This Week with Haley Turner. I'm Michelle Netting. Thanks for joining us. It's harvest time for a farming community, which means tractors will be on the highways. Cassie Hart is in the newsroom with more. Cassie?
Slow-moving heavy machinery can cause major holdups on the roads. We talked to some local farmers to see how they avoid accidents.
In Illinois, there are typically more than 275 motor vehicle collisions with farm equipment on public roadways each year. The highest percentage of these collisions occurs during the fall harvest. There are many ways farmers try to maintain highway safety.
But I usually follow far behind with the combine because I can see cars coming up, and then I communicate either by the FM radios or by cell phone that they're being followed by what I would call our city cousins.
Farmers can also pick up a farm kit to provide added safety. The farm kit is a set of reflective materials which includes a new slow-moving vehicle emblem specifically assembled for farm equipment.
This kit is available from Farm Bureau offices and from many farm equipment and chemical dealers in Illinois.
Last Friday, students from an ethics course gathered for great debate. Owen Russell takes us to the Speaker's Corner.
Created in London's Hyde Park, Speaker's Corner is where people gather and discuss political and moral issues.
My sense is that in our culture, we don't have very many models for thoughtful civil discussion. So, you know, there's people on the radio or on news who will yell at each other, but they're not really talking and trying to understand the other position.
Picket signs, debaters, and soapboxes filled up the quad with intentions of having formatted, focused debate.
This whole semester we've kind of been learning the tactics of debate, how to speak well and not, you know, just use, you know, petty arguments like the Bible says so and this is why.
Some of the issues on the agenda were abortion, saving the whales, contraceptive use, and Walmart censorship.
Put it through a cheese grater and just cut it apart. They ruin music from the way it should be.
For MCTV, I'm Owen Russell.
Organizers consider Speaker's Corner a way to dynamically discuss different world viewpoints. For more information, you can visit speakerscorner.net.
Public speaking is listed as one of people's greatest fears, but a group of people got together last week to celebrate that here at Monmouth. Last Thursday, people gathered to learn about the history of oratory in Monmouth, Illinois. Faculty, administration, and students shared their views on oratory and discussed the significance of one event. That event was the winning oratory from 1881, MC graduate James Erskine. His speech won a Midwest Oratory Contest, which featured among its college speakers three-time presidential candidate William Jennings Bryan and Jane Addams, the first woman to win the Nobel Peace Prize.
I hope that they would be inspired to be an active citizen in the country, which Erskine's speech calls for. Also, I hope that they would see that James Erskine received a very solid education at Monmouth College. I was struck by the historical references that he made. He learned something at Monmouth College, and I hope that students will be inspired to do the same.
The event was also in celebration of the return of Scott Speak to campus. If you're interested in Scott Speak, they meet every Thursday at 4 in Wallace Hall, room 201.
Last Wednesday, to kick off Latino Heritage Month, ASAP held a special event. The evening was filled with Latin food, music, stories, and a dance performance by the group Races under the instruction of Professor Diana Ruggiero. The highlight of the evening was a performance by Gabriela Garcia Medina. This spoken word artist, who has a Cuban heritage, shared some poetry for the first hour of the program.
I would like people to know that my work comes from a very genuine place.
I want to be a practical magician, a wizard of transformation, shaman, high priestess, curandera, brujita, santera, an inventor of light in the midst of darkness, making something out of nothing.
It's like my children, and it's like my children being shared very in a very vulnerable way, and hopefully people will be touched by it the way I am touched every time I perform.
The next After Hours will be October 6th at 9:30 in Scotland Yard, and we'll be dueling pianos.
Taking a look at some events on campus this week. Crimson Mask's first production of the year, The Learned Ladies, begins tomorrow and runs until October 2nd. Tickets are $6 for adults, $5 for students and senior citizens. Tickets can be reserved by calling 309-457-2104 or by emailing theater@monm.edu. Also happening tomorrow, the Wackerly Center is hosting a resume clinic from 7 to 8 p.m. in the lower level of Stockdale. And on Friday, art professor Brian Baugh's art exhibit begins. The reception is from 2 to 4 in the Len G. Everett Gallery.
Coming up in sports after the break. Women's soccer got a victory that's been a long time coming.
Nice try, White. Good play.
It's the same old story. Boy likes girl. Boy takes girl on a date. After the date, boy and girl go back to her place. Then boy falls for the line of, "It's okay, I'm on the pill." Couple weeks later, boy ends up with syphilis. Don't let this happen to you. Remember, the safest sex next to abstinence is to wear a condom. Don't be a fool. Wrap your tool.
Adjectives on the typewriter. He moves his words like a prize fighter. The frenzied pace of the mind inside the cell. The man on the street.
Welcome back. On Thursday, the women's soccer team faced an opponent they haven't beaten since 94, Grinnell. In the team's first Midwest Conference match of the season, the Scots kept Grinnell at a standstill throughout the game. Goalie Samantha Barranco turned in 9 saves at the net. The scoreless run was broken in overtime when Molly Ball slid the ball right under the keeper for the Scots Conference opening win. The Scots defeated Beloit on Saturday as well as Central yesterday. The women play their next game at home against Carroll on Saturday. Haley and Michelle will be back right after this.
Last weekend, families reunited at the Monmouth College Family Weekend. Saturday morning before the football game, students and their families could head out to the quad for some food and fun. A large picnic lunch was served with hot dogs, baked beans, and barbecue chicken. With the marching band playing in the background, kids of all ages could bounce or run on the obstacle course. Free hot air balloon rides were planned for later in the day, but were canceled due to rain.
Logan,
it's a great way to bring all the families together, get to meet other families, enjoy a football game, and go Scots!
And that's MCTV this week. I'm Ross Donnan.
And I'm Haley Turner. Make sure you tune in next week for a new edition of MCTV This Week.
And I'm Michelle Netting. You can also watch us on the web by going to monm.edu/MCTV. But don't turn the channel just yet. A new episode of Fusion is next. We'll see you next week.